I'm Chris Baines, an engineer on the Android Developer Relations team, and I'm here today to give you an introduction to ActionBarCompat. So what is ActionBarCompat? Well, it's a support library that we've released this week as part of the support library version 18, which allows you to add a compatible action bar to your application, but allows it to work from Android 2.1 upwards. Now, ActionBarCompat has been designed to mimic the ActionBar API available in later versions of the platform as much as possible, which makes your job easier. So how do you actually go about adding it to your application? Well, there are two ways we support. First is via Gradle, and it's been added to the Android support repository, which means it's a one-line change to your build.gradle, as you can see here. Or alternatively, you can add it as a library project. You should have a look at the support library release notes for more information on both of these. So for the rest of this DevByte, I'm going to go through a scenario. And that scenario is that you have an application which works on Ice Cream Sandwich and above, but you want it to work on devices from 2.1 and above instead. The first thing we need to look at are your resources, specifically your menus and your styles. So ActionBarCompat includes three styles which you must use, either directly or indirectly. And they are theme.actcompat, theme.actcompat.lite, and theme.actcompat.lite.darkActionBar. Now the keen-eyed of you will see that each of these mirror a theme from theme.hollow, and they act accordingly. So back to our scenario. We have, in our manifest, we have an activity which directly uses the theme.hollow.lite.darkActionBar theme. Now this comes from the Android system. Now to change this for ActionBarCompat, we need to use the theme from ActionBarCompat instead. So that would be the theme.actcompat.lite.darkActionBar theme. But most applications don't use this, and they don't use themes directly. They have customized themes. So here we have a small example with a theme called theme.styled, which has a parent of theme.hollow.lite, which has a custom action bar theme. And that style is referenced below. Now, for ActionBarCompat, we've had to import a lot of attributes into ActionBarCompat, which you have to then use. So there are two rules you need to think about. The first is that your style must always have an ActionBarCompat parent. And secondly, you must always double set each attribute, once in the Android namespace, then again in the default namespace. So back to our scenario. Theme.styled will become this. So rule number one, it has to have an ActionBarCompat parent. So here we've changed it to theme.actcompat.lite. And then rule number two, you have to double set each attribute. Now we've already set it in the Android namespace, as you can see. So we just need to copy that value and do it again in the default namespace, which is the second bit in green. So that's it with styles. As long as you follow those rules, you should be fine. So following on with that, with menus. So as with the standard action bar, items are added to it via the options menu. Now we recommend you add them via menu resources. So here is an example menu resource with one item, a search item. And that item has an action view class of referencing a search view. Now the trouble with this is that it has two attributes which were added in Honeycomb. So you can't use them before. Well, you can, but they'll be ignored. So to get around this, we've sort of imported all of the action item related attributes into ActionBarCompat. So to do that, you need to import them into your namespace. Now we've called it the your app namespace, but you could call it anything you want. And the result is that you need to, for any of the action item attributes, you need to reference them from this namespace, not the Android namespace. So that's it with your resources. We're now going to move on to some code. So the first thing you need to think about is your activity. Your activities need to extend from ActionBar activity. Now, ActionBar activity was added in ActionBarCompat, and it actually extends from fragment activity itself. That means you can continue using fragments, but you must use the support implementation. Now, as I mentioned earlier, the API we've tried to add to ActionBarCompat is very similar to that of activity in later releases of Android. So we have a getSupportActionBar method, which will return you an ActionBar, which has a near identical API to that action bar available in Honeycomb and ICS. So you can add tabs, change the navigation type, or change the home item to act as up navigation. Another method you'll probably use is start support action mode, which will start a contextual action bar. Now, as mentioned earlier, you add items to your action bar via the options menu. So here we have the, so here's an implementation that you would do in Android 1, version 1, where you override onCreate options menu and you inflate a menu from your resources. Now, nothing has changed in this respect. This is exactly the same as you do with ActionBarCompat. The only difference is when you want to start calling methods which were added in Honeycomb or later, such as getActionView we have here, to get the actual reference to the search view. Now, to get around this in ActionBarCompat, we've added the MenuItemCompat class, which is a collection of static methods which will allow you to reference these methods cleanly and safely, much like you do with a lot of the other support methods. Now we move on to fragments. Now, nothing has changed with fragments. You can continue to use Android.support the v4.fragment as you always have. And indeed, to add items to your options menu from there, you just need to call setHasOptionsMenu during your onCreate, and then your onCreateOptionsMenu and onPrepareOptionsMenu will be called. And you inflate them just like you do in your activity. I hope this makes your lives easier, and thanks for watching.